In this video, we are going to learn how to measure the distance using this ultrasonic sensor. And based on the distance, we can either control the steering, which we learned in a previous lesson, or we can control the wheels to either stop, go backwards. I'm also going to show you how to set the code. When the robot starts, your script or code runs. Hi, welcome to a product tutorial by Robojax. This is SunFounder's PICAR-X Raspberry Pi self-driving robot car kit.
Hello friend, how are you? Turn left gear. Countdown to 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Rock. I lost.
Now, to get to the documentation, go to docs.sunfounder.com. From this screen, scroll down until you see robot kits. The first one, PICAR-X car kit version 2 with battery. Click on it. And from here, click on the left side, Python. And we will see all the codes. We are looking at obstacle avoidance. Click. You will see this page, the same as before. Let's run and connect the SunFounder's agent that's not running here. So on the start menu, go there and click Sun, and you will see SunFounder's agent. Just wait for it. We will see the confirmation it's running. Then on the start menu, click PO or power, you will see PowerShell, and run it as administrator. Click here. So this is a screen. Let's ping our robot first. So type ping -4. This means IP version 4. That's the host name dot local, and enter. So our robot is responded, and the IP is this one. 192.168.0.102. Now let's do SSH and connect SSH pi at robojax.local, the same host name. You will put it after the add and enter. It asks for password. The only way to connect from your computer to the robot is that you are connected to the same network or the same Wi-Fi. Otherwise, it will not work. So I got connected. Now, this is one way to write all the programs, this program in here. But there is a simpler way that we can do it directly from the browser. As I open the SunFounder Create Agent, I can connect here. Type your IP address that we just discovered, username and password, which I've explained it before. So we got connected, and this is the same command line that we saw on the PowerShell in here. When I increase the size, the command moves to this screen. If I decrease it, it goes back at the bottom. Now let's remember. So I'm going to type this on the terminal because for the demonstration purpose, the PowerShell screen will be better. So we go to PICAR-X example. I'm typing clear. So let me show you some important thing. P pwd print working directory, it will tell you where you're located at the moment. So this tilde means home Pi in this computer, in this Raspberry Pi. Now CD, just type PI and press tab, example, and now here DIR, we see all the example codes. We are going to run this code. Run it, we will type sudo python 3 and then the name of the program, AV, and I'm typing AV and tab. Now, if I run the code, this might run, so I'm gonna put it facing the ceiling and then pressing enter here. So this is now running because it doesn't see any obstacle, but if I have an obstacle, you see it turns left. Now, because it doesn't see any obstacle, it just goes forward. But if I bring an obstacle like a box, so you see it's responding, but if you're too close, it goes to the left. If you're too far, it goes to the right. Yes, now if I remove it totally, it goes forward. I press Ctrl C to exit. Let's see what is inside this. So I'm typing nano. Nano is an application that you can open text and read them. I just type AV and then press tab, enter. So this is a program that was on that this avoid obstacle. So we are importing from this module, we are importing PICAR-X, we are importing time. And here we have three variables. One is called power, which 50, which is 50, then safe distance, 40, and then danger distance. So unsafe distance, or they call it danger distance, so that's 20. Now we are using these values, so define main, so that's our main function. The cursor is there, let me go with the arrow down. So main is up to here, it's ending, and then finally it goes forward, and this code checks if it is part of the class or main file, then it runs main. So that main that we defined, initially the code comes here and it will run it. Now when the code runs the main, I'm going up with the arrow, here it says try. So it's, we first define from PICAR-X, we define a PX object. While true means forever, because this while is a loop and it needs a condition to be true, so it's always true, so it runs constantly. Now, first we are reading the distance using this function or method called PX ultrasonic read. So this is reading the distance, and we will check this if this is two decimal place or second argument, and then we are rounding it. Here this is a function from Python, and the result is stored in a variable called distance. This is just printing it on the screen that you saw. It prints this text, distance, and then comma, the actual value. The one that was running on the screen was printing by this line. Now we have F, else if, and else. So conditions. The first one says if the distance is greater than safe distance. Safe distance was at the top. Let's see, where was it? Safe distance was 40. And then the danger distance was 20. So if the distance is greater than 40, then set the direction servo angle to 0, which means go straight. So this is, we've learned this in a previous lesson, and sets the power for the forward with whatever value is at the top, which is 50. So the robot will move forward when the distance is greater than or equal to 40. If this is not true, then it's something less than 40 or greater than 20. Then it says if it's greater than 20 and less than 40, then it sets the servo angle to 40. 40 means turn right. The servo of steering servo turns right with the same power, and it goes just for 1/10 of a second, turns very quickly, and stays like that. Otherwise, the angle is minus 40, which means it's not between 20 and 40, not greater than, so it's very small. Then it goes minus 40, it turns left with the same power for half a second. So this is reaction to the distance, but because this is very short time, it exits, so this will constantly run. Because I'm not changing it, I'm pressing Ctrl X and exit. For more videos, please click on subscribe button or click on the icon on the right side of the screen. Thank you. I've written this code for the U-turn. I've defined the power with 50%, reverse power with 30%, and the U-turn distance at 20 centimeter, and we count zero how many U-turn we allow. I want to try for some numbers. It will increment. I'm going to show you later. So we are creating an object PIX from this PIX car. This is a U-turn method. First, we will when we run this method, which I'm going to show you, it will first stop the car, and then we change the angle to 40 degrees. And we are at this position, the car stopped, and then at 40 degrees, we give some time for the servo to turn, and then this is a reverse. The car is going reverse for half a second and it stops. So we are at this stage for half a second, and then we straighten the angle of the steering, and then we go forward for half a second and then stop. And then we go for half a second and stop. For half a second, we are in this stage. Now we are changing the angle back to 40 degrees. And then we go backwards for half a second and stop. So when we go back, we will be something like this. And this method is done. Now let's see the main code runs. First we go forward, and while count is less than 2, which is true because it's 0 at the top, then up to this portion I've explained it. And here we check if the distance is less than U-turn. So this is less than U-turn distance. We run this method, which is at the top. Actually, this counter should be before that. And then we run the U-turn, which will then the U-turn. Otherwise, it goes forward if the distance is safe. So it goes, because now it's 1, after the U-turn, it comes back to here. If 1 is less than 2, again, it will continue, and it becomes 2, it runs. If it's 2 and it comes here, it will exit and it will go forward for 5 seconds and stop. Now let me copy this and paste it here, and let's run the code. I'm gonna run. So the code is running. Now there is no obstacle if I put my hand. So start it. So now one time it continues, it will not stop. But second time, it will, after second time, it will run for 5 seconds and it will stop. Let's do it. Now 5 seconds and it will stop. So now on the table it worked. Now let's see. So now I'm gonna test it with this wall, turning it on. So when it approaches, it should do a U-turn and go there. And let's see if it goes back. It doesn't hit the wall. Anyway, so let's test it. So that's the second one. And that was the problem. I should have created another function, another method to, if it approaches an obstacle, it should stop. Let's say you wrote a code that you are happy with and you want to save it on your robot. Just select and copy Ctrl+C. You copy the whole thing. Open the terminal and let's create a new file. Let's go cd Robojax. Let's create a new file called test.py. So I'm typing nano test.py py. And in here, if I right click, the code will come. Just right click of the mouse. After that, just press Ctrl O and OK and Ctrl X. Now the file tests have been added. If you make any changes to the code, let's say restore, and you want to copy this code, Ctrl C, come back here and open it, and come back here and type nano test.py. The cursor is at the top. Press shift and come down to and select everything. Press Ctrl K to delete, and then right click, it will be pasted. Simple as that. Now save, Ctrl O, enter, Ctrl X. And our file is now updated with a new code. So this is a trick how to update or change or write to a new file in Nano. Now to change the, now let's open it. I'm opening the file. If you want to select any of the text, press shift and select, let's say this line, and then press Ctrl K to delete it. So this way you can press shift and select whatever you want and Ctrl K to delete everything. I've changed my code here. Now it will stop. Now let's copy this, Ctrl A, Ctrl C. I'm going here and right clicking, it will paste. You don't need even Ctrl V or anything. Now Ctrl O, enter, Ctrl X. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next lesson.